This is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to discuss basic Linux commands. So in last session we see how to create directories, right? So how many ways we can create directories? By using mkdir we can create directories, right? So by using mkdir we can create single directory, and we can create multiple directories, and we can create subdirectories. And today we are also going to see how to change directory by using cd options with the different options, and we are also going to see how to remove a directory. Okay, first let's briefly discuss about creating directories. So how do we create directories? I want to create cnutec directory. So how do we create? Mkdir cnutec. So it will create directory. I want to create multiple directories. How do we create multiple directories? Use mkdir and use directory names. Directory 1, directory 2, directory 3, and directory n. You can use n number of directories at a time. So this command creates multiple directories at a time. If you want to create subdirectories, how do we create subdirectories? So we use option mk. I want to create directory like this. So I want to create under root opt. I have directory called cnutec. So this one is already we have created. Under cnutec I want to create Java. Under Java I want to create core Java. Under core Java I want to create fundamentals. Okay, under fundamentals I want to create one more directory, data types. So in this way I want to create directories. Can you tell me how do we create a directory? These subdirectories we use mkdir and under opt, under cnutec, create directory called Java. Under Java create a directory called core Java. Under core Java create a directory called fundamentals. Under fundamentals create directory called data types. Can you tell me, is this command creates Java directory under cnutec? So core Java under Java, fundamentals under core Java, data types under fundamentals, right? Sure. Is this command creates subdirectories, right? No, it will give an error. See, let's see practically so that you will understand. So if user is not listed, click on not listed, enter username and enter password. So right click here, open terminal, go to opt directory, list files and directories under opt directory. So cnutec is already available. Go to cnutec directory. So if you observe in this, there are no files and directories. Come out from cnutec directory. Okay, let's try to create mkdir. So here under cnutec, create a directory called core Java. Under core Java, create directory called Java. Under Java create directory called core Java. Under core Java create a directory called fundamentals. Under fundamentals, create directory called data types. When I try to execute this command, we are getting a error saying no such file or directory. So to create a data types directory, it requires parent directory called fundamentals. Fundamentals is not available. To create fundamentals, core Java directory is required. To create core Java directory, Java directory is required. So this Java, core Java fundamentals are not available. That's why it is unable to create data types directory. How can we give instruction to Linux saying if parent directory is not available, create first parent directory? There is an option called -p. If you give an option -p, first it is trying to create a child directory. What is child directory here? Data types. So to create a child directory, it requires fundamentals, right? Parent directory. So -p gives an indication to Linux saying first to create fundamentals directory. So to create fundamentals directory, it requires core Java directory. So core Java directory is not available. So first it try to create core Java directory. To create core Java directory, it requires Java directory. So for core Java parent is Java. So for parent Java, for Java parent is Sinutek. Sinutek is already available. So first it will create Java. Under Java it will create core Java. Under core Java it will create fundamentals. Under fundamentals it will create data types. Let's press enter. Okay, let's see. LS Sinutek is available. Go to Sinutek. LS under Sinutek Java directory is created. Go to Java directory. Under Java directory you will see core Java. Go to core Java. Under core Java fundamentals are created. Go to fundamentals. Just type one or two characters, press on tab, it will take you complete path. LS under fundamentals it is created data types. Okay, under data types there are no files and directories. So by using this command, by using this mkdir command with option -p, we created subdirectories, right? Okay, now next we will see change directory. Change directory. So to change one directory to another directory, we use command called cd. Cd stands for change directory. Cd space dot. Dot means current working directory. See, currently we are in where? Under, by using pwd command, we know what is current working directory, right? Pwd stands for present working directory. It displays current working directory. So when I say cd space dot, it will enter into current working directory. Just pwd, it is enter into parent directory. Cd dot dot stands for parent directory. Dot stands for current directory. Dot dot stands for what? Parent directory. Parent directory. So parent directory. So when I say cd space dot dot, it comes from child directory to parent directory. Okay, if you want to come two steps back, if you want to come two steps back, it means currently where we are, currently we are under in this directory, right? Currently we are under data types. So to come out from data types, we use cd dot dot. So when I say cd dot dot, it comes to up to that path. So when you type pwd command, we will see this path. I want to come out from two steps back, that is from fundamentals, from core Java. How do we use? We use command called cd dot dot slash dot dot. So when I type present working directory, we will see path this one. We'll see path this one. Let's see practically so that you will see, you will get clear understanding. To clear the screen, we use command called clear. Okay, pwd. Presently we are under data types directory. When I say cd dot dot, it comes out from data types. I want to come out from fundamentals and core Java, two steps back. How do we use? Cd space dot dot slash dot dot pwd. We are under Java directory. So if you want to come out from three steps back, what is the command? Cd space dot dot slash dot dot slash dot dot. So in this way we come out from one directory to another directory. Or assume you are under fundamentals directory. Let's see, you are under data types directory. Go to data types directory. See, currently you are under in this directory. You want to come out from fundamentals directly back to OPT. So if you want to come out from until OPT, how do we use? Cd space dot dot slash, it comes out from data types, dot dot slash, it comes out from fundamentals, dot dot slash, it comes out from core Java, dot dot slash, it comes out from Java, dot dot slash, it comes out from Sinotech. So if you use this path, it comes to what? OPT. Or if you want to know any path, if you want to change one directory to another directory, instead of using this complete multiple steps back, you can directly enter that path slash OPT. So instead of using multiple steps back, if you know where you want to change directory, just use cd slash OPT, it will takes you in this directory. Let's execute pwd command. You will see slash OPT, right? So by using cd command, you can change from any directory to any directory. Okay? Next very important command is removing directories. So to remove directory, we use command called rm. Rm stands for removing. By using rm, we can remove directories, we can remove files. as part of this session, we are going to see how to remove directories. Okay, see, I want to remove fundamentals directory. Assume currently I am in OPT directory. So currently I am in OPT directory. So I am moving to fundamentals directory. Assume I am in core Java directory. I want to remove what? Fundamentals directory. So I am going to use rm command, rm, and I am going to use directory name fundamentals. Can you tell me, is this command removes directory? Yes, removes, right? Sure. Let's see practically whether this command removes directory or not. So we are under fundamentals directory. I want to remove data types directory. Okay, I am trying to use this command rm space data types. See whether this command removes directory or not. So cannot remove data types because it is a directory. Just now we discussed rm command removes directory, but it's saying it cannot remove data types directory because it is a directory. Why it is unable to remove directory? Do you have any idea? So why it is not removing directory means, a directory contain files, a directory contain folders, a directory contain subdirectories, right? If you try to remove directory, it will remove all files and directories, right? So it is asking you, it is saying if you try to remove directory, it will remove all content presented in directory. So it's giving an indication it is not a normal file, it is a directory. So how can we say Linux whether it may be directory, whether it is a directory, I want to remove it. How can we give indication? So we use an option called -r. R stands for recursive. This recursive option removes files and directories presented under data types directory. If there are any files and directories presented under data types directory, first it will remove recursively all files and directories, then later it will remove data types directory. Let's press enter. So here it is asking you to confirmation whether you want to remove directory data types or not. Even though if you give an option called R, it's still asking you confirmation. If this data types directory contain multiple files, it shows multiple files and directories. For each file, it will ask you to confirmation. If I say no, it will not remove directory. Let's execute pwd command. Still, we are in pwd, so ls, still data types directory is available because it is asking you to confirmation whether you want to remove or not. We say what? No. Even though we give an option, -r option, still it is not removed. If you want to remove directory without confirmation, we use an option called rf. When we use rm space -rf, it removes all files and directories presented under data types with data types directory forcibly recursively. Recursively stands for, it will remove all files and subdirectories presented under data types, including data types directory. If F means it will not ask any confirmation, forcibly it will remove all files and directories. Let's press enter. So it will not ask any confirmation, right? Previously it has asked you confirmation. This time it is not asked you any confirmation. Okay, so if you want to remove any directory, we use rm command with option call -r and -f. Okay, so that's it about directories concept. Next we will see files creation. Okay, thank you.